The winter and spring seasons have been mild because the state has been in an El Nino weather pattern.
12 News' Lyra O'Brien has more on what it could mean for the area this summer.
As a meteorologist for the National Weather Service, Rusty Capella is used to looking at data. And the blue he's seeing on this temperature map is catching his eye.
The water temperatures in the Pacific Ocean are still a little bit, a tad above normal, but the projection is based on the scientific results out there is that pattern's going to disappear in the next month or two.
What's been in place for the past several months, an El Nino pattern. For our area, that meant this year's seasonal snowfall totals were down, with stronger storms staying east and south.
Houston, all those southern cities ended up getting snow, and Dallas and so on. But
the El Nino pattern is coming to an end, so what that means for the area for the next few months, more of a neutral trend for summer with a good chance for some cooler temperatures.
Does that mean snow on July 4th or anything like that? No, just some slightly below normal temperatures. That's what the prediction is.
And the chance for above normal rainfall. The forecast is indicating that pattern will not continue into the colder months. With cooler Pacific Ocean temperatures, we could be seeing a transition into a La Nina winter.
If you have a strong La Nina, then the weather pattern favors above normal snowfall and precipitation in the Ohio River Valley. And some of that is in overflows into southern Wisconsin.
Capella says it's still too early to tell if that will happen. More information will be available this July. Now, the last time the area did experience a La Nina winter, the 2008 and 2009 winter, when the area's snowfall totals were more than 20 inches above average. In Milwaukee, Lyra O'Brien, WISN 12 News.